Charles. Any luck finding a mystery woman?
Word is she's been stirring up trouble just outside the city in a town called Lexington.
Well, then that's where we begin our search. I'll meet you there.
Advocate taken out in the street and beaten before the night.
The brother expedition has had small success in recruiting Indian allies to the cause of the crown.
Over here! Hurry! Here! Here!
The French, along with Indian tribes!
Have you found her?
She's made camp not too far from here.
Excellent. Well, the sooner we're done, the sooner we can get out of this cold.
I am afraid I have some bad news, sir.
Oh?
Braddock is insisting I return to service under him. I've tried to beg off to no avail.
No doubt he's still angry about losing Pitcairn. Say nothing of the shaming we gave him. Do as he asks. In the meantime, I'll work on having you released.
I'm sorry for the trouble.
Not your fault.
We're too late.
Fire's only just been snuffed. Snow recently disturbed. She's close.
Bollocks.
His tracks are fresh. They must be hers. Seems she took to higher ground. Out of the snow and into the trees. Wait here. Oh, damn it. Wait, come back!
Do you return to Braddock, Charles, before he grows suspicious? I can handle things from here.
But, sir!
But nothing! Go! Stop running! I only wish to talk! I am not your enemy! Please just hear me out! Gods, woman! Only let me speak! Enough with these games! It is imperative that... Try my patience, woman!
Are you touched in the head?
Me? Haytham, I come in peace.
Why are you speaking so slow?
Sorry.
What do you want?
Well, your name, for one.
I'm Gudzit Zio.
Well, pleased to meet you. Gudzit.
Just call me Zio.
Dio.
Zio.
Dio.
Now tell me why it is you're here. Where did you get this?
From an old friend.
I've only seen such markings in one other place.
Where?
Well, it is forbidden for me to speak of it.
I saved your people. Does this mean nothing to you? Look, I am not the enemy.
Close to here, there is a hill. Meet me there, and we'll see if you speak the truth. That town hosts soldiers who seek to drive my people from these lands. They're led by a man known as the Bulldog.
Edward Braddock.
You know him?
He is no friend of mine.
Every day, more of my people are lost to men like him.
Then I suggest we put a stop to it. Together.
What do you propose?
That we kill Edward Braddock. But first, we have to find him.
I don't trust you.
I know.
Yet you remain.
That I might prove you wrong.
It will not happen.
So you say.
So I know.
Yet, I remain. Wait here. A Mohawkman is likely to raise suspicions, if not muskets.
This is hardly the first time I've been amongst your people. I can handle myself.
I hope so.
We together we alive. I hear tell the French are readying to move on our positions. Wonder what Braddock intends to do about it.
He's already left for the advance camp. I'll wager our little holiday here is just about ended. We'll be marching south before week's end.
It was a game they played with the
pig. Stand being quartered there. The endless crashing of the waves. The sting of the salt in the eyes. And the goddamn gulls shrieking and shitting everywhere.
You're sure that's where we're going?
Aye. The Bulldog's putting together another expedition.
That's what they're calling them now. Expeditions.
Aye. Smart too. Slap a fancy name on something and all evil is excused.
Where are you going, Cully?
Me?
No, the other cock, Robin.
Well, I was leaving.
Oh? And now?
Well, now, I'm going to feed you your teeth.
And you were worried I was going to be the problem? You're hurt.
Oh, that's nothing.
Here. This should stop the bleeding.
That wasn't necessary. But thank you.
We should move on. Meet me at Braddock's camp when you're ready.